Eddie in Madison, Connecticut. Welcome to the Line of Fire.
Dr. Brown, it's been a long time. How are you today?
All good, man. Thank you.
The Bible study, this was something that actually happened to one of the guys in our study, Dr. Brown. His family member, young guy, got married, 22 years old, married for a Christian family, married for 6 months, and the wife just walked out and said, I'm out of here. Here's the papers. See you later. So now what's the response to that young 22-year-old kid who still says, I love women. According to Jesus, now I'm dead. I can't do nothing unless she dies. So I said, listen, I don't know the answer to this, but what I'm reading here, if you do remarry, you're in trouble because you're committing adultery. Now he's like, well, what do I do? My life's over.
Right.
So I said, you got to hope she dies. I don't know. Imagine this. We're praying for death of an ex-wife. I don't even know how to explain it, but it seems like it's so. He's looking at us saying, how fair is that? This girl walks out on me. Now, God, I got to just stay in a room the rest of my life. What do I do?
Right. So first
so I said,
thing.
I have no idea.
Yeah, yeah. First thing is, okay, buddy, it's not the end of the world. There are plenty of people in their 20s who are single. And you can live without sex for a little while. So let's calm down. It's traumatic. It's terrible. It's devastating. But it's not the end of the world. There are plenty of people that love Jesus that are single in their 20s, in their 30s. They haven't met the right person, you know, they for whatever reason. So focus on first, Jesus is enough. Jesus is enough. Start there. That's the first thing. The second thing is, it's not over with this gal. God can bring her to repentance. She can come back. Maybe there are changes God wants to bring in the guy. Now, the deal is that if she does get in a relationship with someone else, and then in that case is the one committing adultery, that I believe based on what Jesus has said in Matthew 5 and Matthew 19, that she can that he can remarry, that she has broken the covenant there. And Paul even says in 1 Corinthians 7, if you're married to an unbeliever, you know, so you're both unbelievers, you get saved, and then they don't want to stay with you, they leave, that you're not bound, meaning you'd be free to remarry. So I would look at that carefully in terms of understanding what Scripture says. I would tell him, hey, first, it's not a panic. You live without sex, you know, through your teen years and before you married this gal, right? You can live without sex for a little while after, or that intimate companionship. God's more than enough. Look, I know people that have been single their entire Christian lives. They just never met the person to marry, and they've been single. I also know others that were divorced many, many years ago. Same kind of scenario. They were, you know, so the person worked out on them and they said, well, I can't remarry. And God was more than enough for them the rest of their lives. But in his case, I would believe that she's either going to turn back in repentance or that her leaving him will ultimately open the door for him to remarry if she doesn't turn back. And what I take advantage of now is as a single person to ask to pray for God to really work amazingly deeply in his own life and to pray for her. And then see if God restores that. If not, then I believe there could be scriptural grounds for him to move on. But don't get all worked up over it. That's the big thing. Don't get all worked up. That's not God. That's either our flesh or the devil. And may the Lord's grace work a miracle in this relationship. Hey, thank you for the call. Hey, friends, I hope you enjoyed that video. If you did, click on one of the boxes on the screen. Check out another one of our videos and be sure to subscribe. And hit that notification bell so that you don't miss a single video. You know, we discovered that about 60% of you that are watching our videos aren't subscribers. So subscribe today. Doesn't cost you a dime. And if you want to support our work, Line of Fire, and all the things that we do, follow one of the links on the screen below.